Diamond Club hopes you have enjoyed this program.
Holy cow. This headline from Vice says, Nazi chic, the fashion craze that won't die.
I'm sorry, the Asian fashion craze.
Okay, that's racist for you to divide.
We're talking about Malaysia.
No, I'm just saying, it's just a fashion craze. We don't have to say for whom. They're people. They're human beings. Wow, that is amazing.
Hey, good show, everybody. What are we going to call it?
Bali.
What if we went to showbot.television?
I kind of like show title or specific title.
I don't know who you
are. That's pretty amazing.
Yeah, show title is pretty good. That specific event.
No, I say just show title. I think show title is what we would actually put as a placeholder, and I think that's the most in spirit of that letter, right? Man, hey, good on us. We didn't even call out during the show, like, oh, God, the pre-show was so scary. Oh. We had so many disasters. It was really rough. Sorry, Thunder. You've been thunderstruck!
Yeah.
You know what was amazing about that is that it's kind of hard to tell which one of us is doing which line when. Like, I was surprised, like, only halfway through a line did I realize, like, oh, wait, it's Justin now, because I remember him saying the GMAs.
I think it's like halfway it goes from you to me.
Yeah.
I could tell. Having listened to it a couple times, I think I was able to pick it out a little bit better this time. Man, I'll tell you what. Hopefully this is not a total, really super negative decision to post all this unedited footage up here. I am definitely, like, normally if it's just me being an asshole, like, it's like I don't care about I think I've demonstrated very clearly that I don't care about my own reputation or repercussions to my actions.
Sure.
But it's like I definitely hope that there's, like, all these clips are really funny and not just, like, you know, embarrassing.
Is it not just you in the clips, or is it because it's tied to
the contender?
No,
it's me. It's just like a product where it's
it's involving on other people.
Yeah,
other
people's. I think it'll be fine. It's gonna be great. I think everyone's gonna have a good time.
Babcat reminds us that we didn't get to talk about the dream.
I think Bonnie was more into it than most. Okay.
We dug into Brian. Like, you know, I think that's another strength of this show, man. Is that, like, you know, there were like three or four, like, hey, let's just, have Brian reveal his vulnerability and let's all take turns flicking it. There were like three moments of that, like, in the show. And it was all, I think we are a stronger show because we are, negative.
My point is, like, I don't mind sharing the dream because it's a recurring nightmare, but I think it's doubly funny when Bonnie can cackle and explain what she finds so funny about it, because it was a combo dream. I've talked about my recurring nightmare of doing a show of techno dance music. My recurring nightmare of doing a show and it not being properly set up and eventually people get up and start leaving. But now I have a new nightmare, which is I keep finding out that I have to dance. And in this case, it was actually Dance Showdown said, oh, sorry, we forgot to tell you. There's one more dance you have to do. You have to fly out to do one more dance. So I do. And I go through the nightmare. Oh shit! I forgot. It is kind of funny. They said the theme for this dream, dance is, oh, I forget the phrase. Bonnie would remember, but being huge.
Oh my God.
And I was like, oh shit! I'm not very good at being huge. I'm a small guy. And being a giant. Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
And so I found some duct tape and a couple of buckets, and I duct taped my feet to the buckets, and then I went and I found cardboard and I wrapped it around my body to fashion armor, and I put plates on, and my dance was
Don Quixote.
It was in a theater. My dance was, I stood on the seats of the theater and stomped around being really tall. And I was like, oh, well, that about does it, right? But then this is the point where my new recurring nightmare blends in with my old nightmare, because I remembered that my entire stage show had been set up, and now they're setting up for, on that same stage that I was not dancing on but around, they were setting up for this giant X Games event. So they were building half pipes and stuff, and it was just coming forward. I was like, oh, I gotta grab the voice distorter for Mr. Happy Pants, and I gotta find, where's my XLR cable? And I was like, my laptop's around here somewhere, and I'm setting it all up, and of course there's no assistant, and I get it all, and I'm like, and next thing I know, I look up at the stage, and it's all just, you know, a skate jamboree park, and I have all my stuff, and so I can't remember whether or not I brought Boxy or the you know, red or blue, I can't find the luggage cart, I get it out to the curb where it's all sitting there. And finally, it's time to, I'm like, oh, I'm finally out. I think I have everything, but I'm not sure. And then this is my new third nightmare, is travel shit not being worked out. And I was like, oh shit, did I book a hotel? And they're like, yeah, well, you know, we thought you were flying out today after you danced. So, you know, we don't have a hotel room for you today. I'm like, oh, I'm pretty sure I worked something out. And then because
frantic scrolling on your phone.
Exactly, right? Oh! And I look and there's nothing there. And I'm like, oh, that's right. I'm in Roswell, New Mexico. And there's only one hotel I would have booked myself out at.
Area 51.
No, I called the Little Alien.
Wait, is this
and I called. The Little Alien? It's a real place, Roswell, New Mexico. The Little Alien, and I called to say, "Hey, do you have a reservation for Brian Brushwood?" And they're like, "Yes, Mr. Brushwood, just come on over." And this is great. There it is. and then I look over at my 200 pounds of magic show horseshit and realize I have no way to drag it across the street or to get over there, and I don't know what to do, and that's the moment I wake up. So that's that was the dream that Bonnie wanted to drill down on.
Nightmare.
Yeah. It was a thing. But at any rate, it was crazy.
Hey, dude. Check this out.
How often do you get those?
Once every other week, I'd say. And the first thought every time I wake up is like, God damn it. Like just to find out that it was all wasted worry, you know, because it's like that is the low grade, you know, I'm sure the way mothers have nightmares about their children being out of their control or whatever. Like, I'm constantly thinking about the next set of travel, the next set of shows, the next set of prep. Anyway, do you have anything like that, Justin?
Oh, constantly. I mean, like, I basically have all the same nightmare, but with different skins. A lot of the unprepared stuff, it used to be college papers, and then it became I didn't have orders ready to go out for when I was working with Andrew, and then it was I was slacking on clients with the Go game, stuff like that, or it's like, you know, that it was, which is funny because I got so good at doing Go games with so little prep that eventually my dreams had to adjust. So it wasn't just like, oh, your Go game's about to start in 30 minutes and you've done no prep. And it's like, yeah, okay, fine.
Yeah. So your dreams had to up. It's an arms race. We were like, and the president's coming.
Yeah. Like, oh no, the president.
Hey, we got somebody calling on Skype right now.
Oh, do we?
Yeah.
He tried to call a little earlier. Hello?
Hey, caller, turn down your radio. What's up, buddy?
Yeah. Sorry. Hey, what's going on, guys?
Hey, man, what's going on?
What's up, sir? How are you?
Brian,
what's your name?
I met you years ago, a couple years ago at OSU.
You were
doing a show.
What is the – oh, Oklahoma State University?
Yeah.
Oh, dude, yes, of course. That was amazing.
Yes. Yeah, that was a good time. Brian, it was funny. I listened to an episode a couple months later. Justin was at 16-bit, and that's one of my hangouts. So I was kind of bummed that I'd missed him in passing.
God, no, that the 16-bit bars are, which they have in Cincinnati. I've been to Cincinnati and Columbus. I haven't been to the Cleveland one yet. But might be enough to justify Ohio as a place where you should visit.
Did you go to Dirty Frank's next door?
Come on, man. What am I, an asshole? You're just going to call me an asshole on my own podcast? Of course I went to Dirty Frank's next door. Of course. It's like the best hot dog place ever. Also,
do you remember what you had?
Which is what Ashley's favorite thing in the world is.
Nice, nice, nice. Do you remember what you had?
God, man. I don't know. The Rhine, Fire on the Rhine.
Oh, that's a good one, yeah.
Yeah. Well, there we go. I've proven that I was there.
So, I have a prediction for Star Wars. I think not only will it be the biggest movie ever, I think Kylo Ren will be Luke Skywalker.
Okay, look, we're not a spoiler cast, bro.
It's not a spoiler. It's
I've
prediction.
Never heard of Luke Skywalker before. What is this shit? You come into my house, you gotta tell me about who's Iron Man. You gonna spoil that next?
Well, that's kind of a basic spoiler, right?
Like, and I don't mean basic as in everyone should know it. I mean like basic as in basic theory. Kind of what they want you to think.
Well, that's what certainly a number of people are saying. It says though they pointed all the clues in that direction.
I think the biggest giveaway is he's not on the poster.
How about the biggest giveaway that it's not him? It's like he's got Adam Driver's skinny boy, skinny jean hips. You see him just walking through the snow?
Maybe. I don't know. It's a J.J. Abrams film, so it's fun to play into the hype.
Oh, yeah. I think that they're very deliberately creating a lot of opportunities. I would be shocked if it's that.
Yeah.
Great. Well, thanks for calling in and giving us your theories.
Yep. Hey, Brian, I'd like to be on... Killer sometime.
He definitely has his fingers in his ear, so I'm sorry, but it sounds like he did not get to hear you. We're good. We're all good.
Sorry, I was just jamming out for a second.
What were you jamming out to? Was it
BrodaQuest.
BrodaQuest, okay.
Yeah. In fact, if you go back JFK style, it looks like he's making random syllables, but it lines up perfectly with BrodaQuest.
Hey, fun behind the scenes story with the contender dancing video. It was literally me dancing to Rihanna's S&M song over and over and over again, and we just found a song that had the same BPM.
That's amazing.
So I would look like I was dancing to that, but it meant that I was literally the more ridiculous situation is that I was literally just dancing to Rihanna's fucking S&M song.
No, but S&M is a jam. It's a banger.
It's a great song. Yeah, it's a hell of a dancer, man.
I'd play it if I won Skirt of Content ID.
If you didn't want to annoy Leon the Great of Howard, yeah.
That is awesome. Well, shit, man.
The only thing I didn't like about S&M was that, like, that was that point in pop music where every pop song had to be a like bumper sticker, where it was like, you know, sticks and stones may break my bones, but whips and chains excite me has been like, you know, a bumper sticker or like, you know, novelty t-shirt for 10 years.
You're saying it's not written to be a bumper sticker. It's taken from bumper stickers.
No, taken from a bumper sticker. Yeah. And there was like Pink had a couple songs in a row that were all just like, like Hot Topic t-shirts that they just ripped off wholesale or whatever.
Yeah.
It was a very weird point where it was like, oh wait, no, let's just pick things that people have known forever.
Yeah, man. Weirdly, I hate to acknowledge it, but that's that, and I don't mean to sound like I'm dogging on a site that I read every day, but that's that Reddit culture. Like, if you want karma, here's an idea: post shit that already blew up on Reddit. And then, you know, step two, let it blow up on Reddit. Step three, hear five people complain about the fact that you reposted it. Profit. You know, that's the thing. It's like, we already know this is profitable and these things are hook-worthy and that they stick around. And so let's just make them into songs.
It is amazing. Like, even, you know, so I had this thing with the Contender dancing video, right? So he posted it on the Contender Facebook and I shared it on my account, right? And 300 people see it, you know, maybe 500 people see it. I posted on my own account as my own video, like 2,500 people or 2,500 views, mm-hmm. right? And how many people saw it the first time? Who knows? Because Facebook blocks that content. But even if they didn't, like, it doesn't matter. Say the same thing over and 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 over again if you want people to hear it. Like, that's like we like to think that, like, it's our own perspective of, like, but I'm posting this for the seventh time. Doesn't matter.
Yeah.
Most people don't see it.
I'll tell you what, in a mild form, you know, there's that's kind of what we're taking advantage of with Scam School Remix, you know, is the fact that virtually nobody has gone back and watched this episode from 2009. And it's like, it's just dead as hell. And I'm 30 minutes away from some Irish magician performing the exact same thing with the same script and the whole world coming all over their own faces as if, you know, he invented it for the first time, you know?
Oh,
so I might as well
explain something that'll blow your mind.
You won't believe what happens next.
Well, you know, this is a thing I came up with. It's
it's a little puppet. He's called Mr. Happy Pants.
Yeah.
Oh, hello, Mr. Happy Pants.
Oh, yeah. Oh, hi, Mr. Happy Pants. You're a bunch of wankers.
I was down in Satanville. So I was. I was talking to my buddy Beelzebub, and we decided, you're an ass. Now stick a needle through me.
Like, oh, no, you notice that I, you know, when you stick it in, like, it comes out the other side, right? You know, you can go ahead and touch it. I invented this, you know, you just go ahead. It's the same thing, you know, you just go ahead and touch it.
Oh, what's this? A little turntable with some cups on it, eh? Let me spin it around. I hope there's not a knife under one of these. Oh, golly. I sure did stab myself on a knife.
Oh, well, I to tie to tie. You know, the history of fire eating.
I was reading these books the other day, weren't I? They're three very popular books. Maybe I'll just riffle through and you'll pick a word, huh?
It was an art, you know, that Houdini said himself. What was the wings of oblivion or something? I don't know. You know, it was gonna go and envelop the art of fire eating. It was out of the theaters and you know, into the streets, you know.
Well, I noticed the other day I was watching some videos of some old television static, huh? And I decided to take a picture with my cell phone. Look at that. What's on there? Looks like a ghost's face, don't it?
Nathan Bogota.
Have you ever thought? I mean, I know that this is something that you don't do very often anymore. But with EVP, the conceit in that has always been like that it is home video, right? That you are like finding on VHS or whatever.
No. The conceit was, let me see how easily I can access the script because it's fallen out of rotation. I asked, how many of you guys have seen EVP, electronic voice phenomenon? And I explained the idea of it, the idea of ghosts getting caught on tape. And I say, something weird happened, back in the 1980s up in, Vermont. There was a family moved in, or this guy, I show a picture of a guy, some old historical dude I found on Google Images. I was like, his name.
This is the bit we call ruining the magic.
and his name's John Chambers, born in the late 1800s.
Died. You know, his name is John Chambers. You know, he was in the States, and he was in Vermont, and you know,
he died. He died. He died in the mid 80s. And the couple who bought the house that he lived in. Report all kinds of strange phenomena, but they caught one of it on videotape. They were watching a TV show back in the 1980s, and they happened to take a photo. And they said that when they took a photo, they could see. Oh no! I say, oh shit! I'm gonna have to watch the tape. They caught one of it on videotape. I say I'm gonna play the tape of what they saw. They were watching an old television show. The signal went on crazy, and they caught it on videotape. I'm gonna play a tape. I'm gonna play you what it looked like. Tell me if you see anything weird. And I play it, and it's actually between you and me and the walls, a clip from the Cosmos DVD from Carl Sagan. Like, you see like 2 seconds as if they're watching Cosmos in the 1980s, because I wanted
something. Yeah, it's like a boat or something, right? Like
it's like crowd shots walking, it's B-roll, right? And then it goes to static and flickers up and down, and then to create kind of this weird pregnant thing in the background, I recorded myself actually whispering the script to the fire eating. I was like, the concept of fire eating is old as history itself, as far back as the ancient Christianity Medea. And I played it backwards and forwards and all that stuff.
So that's being whispered just in the mix, so it just feels eerie.
Yeah, correct. And so it's mixed in with the static, and then
I've never noticed that, but there definitely is like, but because like I guess I just always wrote that feeling off to just like how well it is done.
Game School New York Magic Show, and I think you could see it enough that you could probably catch it. I think it's part two of it. Okay.
Here's the thing.
And then jump forward to about the, I'd say the little 60% mark. Yeah. There you go. A little bit.
Television static. You might see an image like this. The image of what looks like a woman wearing a black hat from the 1800s. This next one to me looks like a grin tape of what they saw. But I want you to watch it the way they saw it the first time, just with your eyes. Put your cell phones down. I'll tell you when you need them. But see if you notice anything weird here. Check it out.
So that whispering in
now,
there.
Just about everyone who sees that footage reports nothing unusual about it, but the couple who recorded it swear they happened by a random chance to snap a picture of that static, and when they got back the developed photo, they said they could see John Chambers trying to contact them through that static. So I want you to watch it again, this time through your cell phone camera. If you have a low light mode, put it in low light mode. Those of you in the back, use your Zoom. Now remember, this is an experiment, so maybe
this is the night I met Patrick Delahanty. He sent in one of the photos you're about to see.
Snap a picture of it, make some noise, and hold up your camera so we know something's happening out there. And make sure to show me after the show, because no two phones seem to get the exact same image. Let's see what happens. Who saw a face? Hands in the air if you just saw a face. Here's the thing. I tried this.
You can kill her right now because it's the payoff is, you know, we do a screamer at the end. We say, I've been told that you see a face, but at this point half the people have seen the face. The other half have, you know, not seen it, but maybe they see it on a person next to them, or they really want to know what they missed. And I promise that if you play the tape backward, they'll be able to see it. And of course, it plays it and sucks them in, and then does the screamer at the end. That was a long way to answer your question,
number
Justin.
One, this bit's so good, and it's so strong. I really can't say enough about how rad your show. And also, was true or false? That was the first direct contact you had with Andrew Main, right?
That was in New York. Was he there for the New York show?
No. That routine.
Yes. No. As a matter of fact, I knew I liked. I believe I had just started to use Gmail at the time. I'm gonna write down Andrew Main.
You know what I love about this YouTube video?
Huh.
So the previous comment was a year ago. The most recent comment was a month ago, and all it says is them flip phones.
Then flip phones.
Them flip phones.
Oh, man, back in the day.
You know what I think?
Huh.
Adele saw this shit. She's like, put it in my video.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay. Prove me wrong. Wow, man. I guess it predates my use of Google Mail.
Mm. Of Gmail. So yeah. As I know it, Andrew had two references to you before we were friends.
Yeah.
One was that he had heard from people that he had known that were like had been at college and like magicians had come through, that there was one magician that was really, really, really awesome and one magician that was underwhelming. And I won't name the magician that was underwhelming, but I'll text it to you.
Okay, good.
And that he had heard that you were doing an EVP thing, and he wanted to make sure or wanted to know whether or not it was the same method as Ghost Vision, because like in the realm of magic, and again, magic is 70 people.
Yep.
There were two people that were doing effects that had a ghost appear on any television screen. Now, both of you guys are doing it in supremely differently clever, super amazing ways.
Right.
And Andrew's is perfect for
up close
doing
and
in a street magic-y kind of way. You are perfect for doing it in a stage kind of way.
Yep.
But that was where you guys came into contact, was you guys double checking each other's, like, hey, we're here, we're doing the same thing.
Yeah.
Are we doing the same thing or are we doing a different thing?
He was totally cool. And I could tell it was a fast friendship because I was talking about, and once I shared my method, he was like, oh, because I was thinking maybe this method would work for stage. And in typical Andrew Vane format, he goes, here's a prototype I made. It doesn't work as well as I want. He sent me a file of it. And I was like, oh, yeah, that's clever. And we got to talking. And then I was like, you know who you should talk to is this other programmer guy that I know. And this is when I knew I was going to be friends with Andrew Vane. When I was like, hey, can I forward this on to this programmer guy who I worked with on this? And he goes, yeah, sure. Unless you think he's a communist or something. And there's something about that being our third interaction that really tickled me. And I'm so happy that later on everything looped around. No shit. Really? I wouldn't have guessed that.
Underwhelming, if not smarmy and shitty.
No. I can see that for that time period.
Yes. Oh,
I think
he
has
evolved, become a better person.
Best people, to be honest. I mean, it's so funny because I remember so many magicians. There was this scarcity mentality among the college market in the early days. And so many people were all worried that the other one was going to steal our golden goose. And nowadays, all of us have TV shows and don't care. And we're all successful in other domains. It's amazing.
It's almost as if it would have happened if everybody was nice to each other the entire time.
It's as though a wise person said that talent doesn't fear talent. And that, I'm telling you, man, that's some life changing advice. Like, if you think you have it, then you have nothing to fear from other people also having it.
Well, the thing that I've always kind of meant with that was that, like, really, and this is something that came back with, like, Big Jim today. Big Jim was on Twitter, like, asking me, you, Carboni, and Merritt and a few other people, major spoilers, Steven Schleicher, about, like, hey, have you ever put a bunch of heart and soul into something and then had somebody completely take the piss out of you online in comments? And, like, how do you deal with that? And I kind of wrestled with it a little bit. And then I kind of realized that, like, what really affected me was when I read comments that I had insecurities about.
Oh,
you
and
know,
that
comments
continues
comments that,
to be
yeah,
the
comments
to be
that
the
are
thing.
Just completely out from left field. That are just like, if someone's like, "You're ketchup, you're not a human, you're ketchup," and you're like, oh, "Well, that doesn't make sense.
Well,
like,
and,
that doesn't make any." There's
that's why I melted down when exactly five magicians got bent out of shape when I taught how to make your own, you know, rough and smooth deck, is because I don't like everybody talking about my hair or being a twat or whatever. It's like, you know, I know I'm not a twat. I'm a human being who has a Y chromosome, and it's impossible for me to have a vagina, and I couldn't be a, you know, 5.5 foot tall vagina.
It's like the
possible.
Onus is on you to learn more about biology.
Yeah, exactly. And same thing with, like, you know, dumb hair. It's like, look, I know my hair is rad and you're fucking stupid, so whatever. But having you know, I wrestled a lot with, you know, because there ain't no rule book on hey, in the face of changing technologies, the entire rule book for magic teaching is going to be thrown out there, and it's like, oh, by the way, the spotlight's on you, what are the rules? And so I really wrestled with it, and it's because I tried so hard to come up with a consistent you know, set of ethics. But, you know, what, you know, I didn't have the benefit of, you know, 7 years of working out the details on it. It's because it was a soft spot that it was so painful for me to for anyone to poke me on that stuff. And it took years, literal years, until I recorded that Ethics of Teaching Magic thing.
And, you know, that was something where it's even like it's hard for anybody to tell you that, because, like, I mean, that's when we were close, and it was like, you know, I could tell you, I was maybe, I mean, among everybody that is close to you, that whose opinion you value, I might have been the person that A, had experience with the Magic Cafe, right? Mm-hmm. The people that were organizing against you, had a sense of where this argument was in any kind of reasonable way that wasn't sucked into that that sphere, and knew all of the five magicians that were yelling at you, and had specific experience with all of their motivations and where they came from, right? And I could lay all that out to you in as much detail as I could, in ways that you could say now would be like, yes, I would have hoped that somebody would have explained that to me at the time, and it was explained. However, and it ain't specific to you, it's human nature. Like, when it's in your own head, it's in your own head. Like, there's just, you can't look at it rationally. Like, it just doesn't happen like that.
Well, and it was the first time that I understood. I had never had panic attacks until that moment, because I couldn't solve the puzzle of how to... Because the one move I knew I could not do was play defense. I could not appear in the Google News search for apologizes for, right? I was like, especially if it's something that I believe was fine, it's a complicated discussion, and all I wanted to do is have that discussion, but I knew that the moment you walk in to that den and try to have a discussion, you can't do it. And again, logic, you know, everything's fine, but you find yourself, it was the first time I understood that a panic attack is not rooted in logic, and you can't logic away the desire to vomit. You know, it's like, there's no amount of explanation to your own body you can make.
No. And at the end of the day, either you are going to wrap your head around it and understand it, but like, what you need to do for that is to just be stronger within yourself. Yeah. You know, like you getting over that was you understanding where you stood on these issues, not necessarily whether or not these people were ever going to like or respect you. Yeah. You know?
Dude, I'm sorry. I cannot get over how adorable Blurch is.
It's
pretty much the perfect baby. She's so adorable.
Tez
ain't bad either, but Blurch.
Can I ask a question?
Yes.
Because, and I want to know when it happened. There has to be like a day, a Mason-Dixon line.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, man, I really shouldn't have this conversation when I'm drunk, because I don't want it to come off as offensive.
When did I become a dad? Doing no, dad shit and oogie booing on.
Tez, who's the best, and we loved her on the show. But there was a point in which girls, females, stopped getting tattoos on their necks of things of like solid animals or designs, and everything became script tattoos.
You know, like, what? Bryn has a number of script tattoos on
script
her arms.
Tattoos. Yeah. I wanted to know when was the day that script tattoos happened?
You know, I don't, this is why I don't do tattoos. This is why I'm like,
has anyone else noticed this? Especially chicks with script tattoos on their ribs. That became a thing where like all of a sudden there's a dividing line where it was like, now all of a sudden what were callously referred to as like tramp stamps or lower back stamps, those went out, right?
And well, that's the problem, right? Is it until
Jesus, R&R.
All right, let's fold forward and just say that, man, tattoos are an interesting shifting landscape of what is in and out. Take a look at this video.
Hey, we have a new video from our best friend.
Oh, it's new?
MAM. I believe so. He's going to show us how Dynamo works.
This is the illusion where Dynamo walked into a woman's boudoir.
Wait for this.
Boudoir.
He grabbed a knife from a table and proceeded to cut himself on the palm of his hand. The woman was then mightily impressed when the blood from the cut disappeared and the wound was gone. How could this possibly be done? It is all in the knife, which was placed on the table earlier by Dynamo or one of his assistants. The knife is hollow and spreads a thin red liquid when pressed into something solid, much like a fountain pen. How did the liquid disappear right before our eyes? Some people suggest CGI is the only possible way. Not necessarily. In my youth, I brought from a magic shop a blue liquid that looks like ink. It is intended that you accidentally spray it on someone's shirt. The person usually gets upset, but after a minute or two, hopefully before you get beaten up, the colour disappears and the liquid turns to water, especially if you rub it. I suspect something similar with the red liquid is happening here.
Wow, I didn't realize that nobody watches these videos. I think
Nice nips.
Yeah, that's the thing.
Of his hand. The woman was then mightily impressed.
Oh my God! All right, wait, Bryce.
Oh, Jesus, I didn't catch
Bryce,
that.
Bryce, yes. Just this clip to Hotline Bling.
Oh, shit.
What's Hotline Bling?
Oh, Brian.
Go on, bring it. Explain to me.
You used to call me on
my... Oh, shit, okay, got it. You used to. I thought it was a website.
You used to call me on my cell phone. Why would you need my love? Call me on my cell phone. Why would you need my love? I know when I love it. Like you know me, I love it. I know when I love it. Like you know me, one day. Ever since I left the city.
That's amazing.
Oh.
That is amazing.
You and me, we just don't get along. What, how this possibly could have been done?
We had talked about we need to do something tonight.
Oh, shit. Yeah, we got to bust that out right now. I have to record an ad for domain.com. You guys want to watch? Yeah, let's do it live.
Listen in, Jerry?
Oh, yeah, sure.
Okay, I'm going to have you and myself turn down a little bit once we get started, okay?
Okay.
Gotcha.
So basically the idea is, you know those conspiracy videos?
There's a number of them out there, Justin. People have conspiracy theories.
And to give you a sense of the style, it's just like, just footage. It is all footage, straight cuts as someone's talking over it, sometimes not well recorded, whatever. And explaining whatever, 9/11. 9/11 happened like this.
However. Sure.
That's the most classic. 9/11 happened like this. The motion picture.
JFK is a little more classic, but yes.
Sure. Yes. Okay.
Oh, that's fine.
And so we thought we would do a sort of take on that, where I've found a list of royalty free or available footage that we can use.
Okay.
And so we're going to kind of modular this out a little bit, possibly.
Yeah, yeah. You will blend all of my comments mm-hmm. out or into one narrative.
One thing.
Let's take a look at the clips.
Okay. The first one, some of these are real short. Oh, geez. So this is like a time lapse of a New York City traffic street intersection. Oh, geez. Come on.
That was it. It was a 3-second time lapse. It was a half second time lapse of 3 seconds of New York.
Oh man, let me try the WMV. There we go.
Great.
And
that's good.
And I think for some of these shorter ones, we can reuse them or just
chirp.
You know, play them again in slow motion.
Oh, by the way, don't underestimate the value of replaying the same clip 12 times. Yes. So goddamn funny.
We've got a Dewdrop. On a leaf.
Okay.
Something. We have footage of Amelia Earhart taking off in an airplane.
That's good.
Some shots of her, some shots of her plane taking off, her crew. Looks like she's putting brewskis in there. What's the sound? I'm putting the sound effect in because none of this footage had sound. This is before sound existed. So that's that. This video of a cat. This adorable cat doing something. I don't know what this cat is doing.
What is this cat doing?
The video says he's talking. But it's like he's meowing but not saying anything.
All right, keep going.
We have the video clip of the raising of the flag at Iwo Jima, another very short one.
Okay,
which makes it just like doubly funny to repeat over and over again.
Yeah.
Some fireworks exploding, a campfire. This is like a strange angle on a campfire. But
oh, that's great. That's great.
Yeah.
Perfect.
A vinyl disc, just footage of a vinyl disc spinning.
Okay, real quick on this vinyl disc thing.
Yeah.
Can you add a vinyl sound effect underneath it?
Mm-hmm.
Because there's a
click. There's a little characteristic click sound, sort of that vinyl.
So the style of this. What if we did it similar to if you search YouTube real quick, mm-hmm. just type in Amen Break.
Oh, sure, sure, sure.
Have you seen that particular video?
I know of the Amen Break.
But specifically, I want to ape the style of this video. Amen Break. That there. Look at the beginning of this, right?
This is Nate Harrison, recording in winter of 2004. I'd like to talk about drums, or rather, about a particular drum beat. I'm sure you've heard it dozens of times before. It's a ubiquitous piece of the pop culture soundscape. It's been used as a rhythmic backdrop in everything from late 80s gangster rap to corporate America's recycling hip-hop forms to sell things like Jeeps and blue jeans to suburban America. In fact, just last week, I saw a TV commercial for a pharmaceutical company where this drum beat was used to promote some sort of purple pill.
Have you watched this video?
It's been used so much.
I have not. No.
So good.
The collective audio it's
long. It's like 15, 20 minutes. So I don't think we'll watch it right now.
Yeah.
But maybe we could do that aesthetic for the beginning.
Oh, God. So, oh, interesting. So it's like playing over.
Yeah, no. Wait, here. Keep listening to him explaining stuff on here.
Many people during hip-hop's early years didn't see it and other sample-based music as having
any potential
beyond a limited underground appeal. During the 80s, when DJs plundered old jazz and R&B records looking for samples, hip-hop in particular and electronic music in general were not the pop phenomena and moneymakers we know them as today. There seemed to be a brief few sort of glory years back then when the novelty of sampling and the rate at which it was being employed as a new technique grew faster than the rate at which any sort of copyright bureaucracy could maintain the law. Older bits of sampling were appropriated, perhaps under the assumption of their being able to be freely used, in the spirit of a pledge to new forms.
Because I think that
in
vinyl clip
words,
that I have is
sampling was not
bit.
Seen as merely rehashing
oh,
past
great.
Sounds,
so
but as an attempt to
that,
make
that,
new
that
from something
of,
old.
Like,
an artistic strategy
random footage clips?
Oh, no, all of the above. I'm just saying, like, maybe I, you know... maybe I ape the style of that. What else do we have?
So this will be great for conspiracy. It is if it'll load archive. It is footage. Here we go. It's some government footage of an underground explosion. No sound. From the U.S. Atomic Energy Commission.
Yeah, that's great.
That's very good stuff. We've got a. This is a part of a film, but. This film, they Sex Madness, has a burlesque show on a stage. About here. No, too far. But it's a clothed burlesque show rather. But.
Let me hear the beginning of that Amen Break thing again, just so I can try to ape his style. I'll just say a bunch of stuff, and you could put any of this footage on there. Can you send me that list of scenes?
Yep. Alright. Sent. Okay, so here's how that video starts again.
He actually sounds a bit like the style of Roman Mars.
This is Nate Harrison, recording in winter of 2004.
There we go. That's it. In fact, I'm going to say recording in winter of 2004.
the other just two things, because you don't need to see them, is Night of the Living Dead is a public domain movie.
Okay.
And we have Three Stooges episodes at the Wazoo.
Great.
So, let me so I'm going to go dark, and Justin, you're going to be dark, and wave your hands or something if you want me to bring you up. So we can hear you. Okay.
Oh, by the way, as you put this on there, it might be worth it to ever so slightly pitch shift me down a bit so I sound a little bassy and,
okay.
And better. This is Brian Brushwood recording in, winter of 2004. This is Brian Brushwood. This is Brian Brushwood recording in December. Fuck. Sorry. Shouldn't do this drunk. This is Brian Brushwood, recording in winter of 2004. People believe there's a tapestry of truth. That what you are... Yeah, hold on. Let me do this. Here we go.
Yeah, just lean into it.
The important thing is promo codes. We're back to promo code Scam School?
Yes. 15%.
All right. This is Brian Brushwood, recording in winter of 2004. We're fed a tapestry of lies. We're told what reality is. Up is down. Black is white. Day is night. I feel fright. All these things are lies. And yet we gather together, as if around a campfire of lies, toasting marshmallows of lies, smearing them on graham crackers of lies. When we gather together, the truth becomes true. The sky becomes blue.
I did like, what is it, when we come together, truth becomes
yes,
true.
Yes, okay. When we come together, the truth becomes true. When we come together, the truth becomes true, and we see life for what it actually is. Who is this woman? What is this cat doing? Hi. Who is this woman? What is this cat doing? That's a big explosion. These are what the government wants you to believe. But there's only one truth. That if you want fast, easy, and reliable web hosting, you need to go to our friends at domain.com. Use promo code SCAMSCHOOL for 15% off. You'll have a domain before you even know it, and the reliability of a .com or a .net. That's what they don't want you to know.
Credibility of a .com or
a .net. Reliable. Sorry. Use promo code SCAMSCHOOL for 15% off at checkout, and you'll get the credibility of a .com or a .net. That's what they don't want you to know. And by they... I mean the Hispanics. No. Who should they?
By they, I mean us.
Oh, yeah, they're. Yeah, that's. And by. No. I was going to say by they, I mean me. Okay, right. Yeah, there. Okay, there we go. Use promo code SCAMSCHOOL at checkout, and you'll get 15% off, and the... Use promo code SCAMSCHOOL at checkout. Not only will you get 15% off, but the credibility of a .com. At least, that's what they want you to know. or the credibility they don't want you to have?
They won't tell you about? They don't want you to know is probably the best of
I think. Okay, all right. All right. Use promo code SCAMSCHOOL at checkout. Not only will you get 15% off, but you'll get the credibility of a .com or a .net that they don't want you to know about. And by they, I mean me. Hail Satan. Sorry.
That's it.
I don't want to say, I don't want to say Hail Satan.
We cut it before that.
Okay. Okay.
It was good. That's good.
Okay. All right.
It's in there.
Good.
Thank you.
The end. Apologize.
What's that?
Fuck up the end and apologize.
Oh yeah, me.
Okay.
You're a shitty conspiracy video, right? So you should be like, and by that I mean me.
Sorry, I dropped the mic.
Sorry. Like, is it? I'm sorry. I'm gonna re-edit this. I'm gonna repost it.
All right. Here we go.
And actually, I don't know. I like the idea of like maybe he's being walked in on recording this. But I don't know.
The only thing is that requires acting, which I don't know that we could pull off right now. Okay, all right, here we go.
Okay.
Use promo code SCAMSCHOOL at checkout. Not only will you get 15% off, but the credibility of a .com or a .net that they don't want you to know about. And by them, I mean me. Sorry, I dropped the... I'm sorry. Subscribe to my YouTube channel, guys. I'll do better next.
Oh, it cut out perfectly. Oh, that's good.
Oh, did it? All right, let me try another one.
Okay, one more.
Use promo code SCAMSCHOOL at checkout. Oh, that's right. Use promo code SCAMSCHOOL at checkout. Not only will you get 15% off, but you'll get the credibility of a .com or a .net that they don't want you to know about. And by they, I mean me. Oh, God. I'm sorry. Hold on. Can I edit? Subscribe. Like and subscribe.
Yeah, I like that.
I like the first one because you dropped the chord in the perfect mid-apology.
Okay, great. Yeah. Great.
That's great. That's in there.
All right,
thanks
good.
Thanks so much.
Good.
Were you guys talking about something else also similar to this that you guys were thinking of doing on the air? Something about titles or I don't know, have people vote on something? I don't remember what the
idea
was.
Oh, yes!
Oh, Captain Morgan!
God damn it, Tango? Yes.
Hey, Brian. Yeah, hi.
You're trying to get a...
Hey, Captain Morgan's here. Brian, I have a song in my heart.
Wait. Oh, there we go. Is the song Please Make Me Famous on Vine, the musical?
There's everyone on Vine is black-hearted. They're mean, and they're not just a race of people.
Oh, jeez. Okay. Yeah, so here's the thing we figured out. We've got a collection of four vines that we want to... do I need to forward these over to you? Bryce, or you have
Yes, please. Do.
Okay, yeah.
Or are they on like a place? Are they on a place?
That you can send me a link to? Here we go. I'm gonna send you a thing.
But so you guys have these vines made up, and you need
Here's what we realized is that half of the joke is the title that sets up the punchline.
Yeah.
That's the key to a successful vine is you read, you know, when you're blankety blank blank, and then you get there, you're like, Nash, come. And I sent
like
you
this
a
could link. Be its own little like live stream.
What's that?
Like, well, no, let's play it. But I think in the future, if we get a bunch of them, we could like just go live for a half hour or 45 minutes and just like,
Do you want to hold off on doing that right now?
No. These I feel like, listen, we built it up. Everybody's, if you're still watching now, you deserve to be rewarded.
Okay, so here's what we're going to do. We're going to play you a vine, and we need you to come up with a title for the vine that will engage people to click on it and watch, but also make the video pay it off. When your friend gets drunk too early before, and it was me and Captain Morgan.
So, for example...
Yeah.
The headline is the setup.
Yep.
The 6-second vine is the punchline.
Correct.
It's the funniest setup.
So in this case,
non sequitur that's happening here.
In this case, I think this is the first one we did where it's like when your friend passes out too early.
Captain.
Captain, wake up.
Yeah, your mom's woken up from a pussy coma.
So this is the first one up for discussion, yes?
Okay, yeah, so we're... Oh, wait, this is the new one. Yeah. Sorry, I apologize. Mm-hmm. Keep going.
You're awake, pussy! We're so happy to have you. It's Christmas! You're awake, pussy! We're so happy to have you. It's Christmas!
So maybe we can make this a continuation of the first one, because this is the waking up from the pussy
wakes
coma.
Wakes up from that pussy coma?
Yeah. Yeah.
You're awake, pussy! We're so happy to have you. It's Christmas!
I like to imagine that this is a Christmas Day vine, and it's like when your little brother who's sleeping in finally comes downstairs or something. That feels more pointed.
Yeah. Well, and plus also
No, that's where we want, right? Okay. And I think that we can keep thinking on it, but it's like I think like you want to be evocative and bring people in on a joke or a situation, right? Like it can't be too non sequitur considering like there's a literal cat on screen, right? Mm-hmm. And the Christmas thing I think can be a non sequitur punch. So we don't want to say like that might be like, you know, like when your friend wakes up too late or something.
We called it when your asshole friend passed out from drinking too early. I wish there was a way to tie it from that.
Well, but does it help it or hurt it to tie it to this other one? Because then it's like, you know, suddenly you have this thing that requires parts.
No.
By the way, Beef just, I mean, and again, like, this is Brian's, we are operating on the Schwood Vine account, right? So there's only so far we can go, but it would not be unvine to just name it Sleepy Bitch.
I mean, it would just one more time. Think about this. Sleepy Bitch.
You're awake, pussy. We're so happy to have you. It's Christmas.
Jesus, I don't want to go miss. I mean, he's misogynist, but the title.
Because it's your. This is the problem with it being your account, right? Yeah. That it's just like Captain Morgan's Vine account, because Captain Morgan would name it Sleepy Bitch.
Shit.
So the first one was when your friend passes out at the bar, right?
No. When your asshole friend passed out from drinking too early.
Okay.
Was the first one, yeah.
So when you wake up your lightweight drinking partner.
I would say we don't have to necessarily make it a when you. We could say
Emeritic W says when you wake up from a one night stand.
You're awake, pussy. We're so happy to have you. It's Christmas.
Okay, now, if you're... that's pretty good. morning after worst one-night stand.
You're awake, pussy. We're so happy to have you. It's Christmas.
You know what I love about the cartoon feature element of this is that it makes it seem like it is from something else.
Yes, exactly. Like we ripped this off of the 2-hour Christmas special of Captain Morgan.
Yeah.
I like morning after the worst one night stand or something.
I'm fine with either. I think it might be cleaner for just be like when you wake up after a one night stand.
The only thing is that implies that you're about to impart a universal truth. Like it would be funnier if like, you know, when I wake up from a one night stand or.
Well, no. That's the language of Vine.
Yeah.
Is like, you know, because there's a whole cottage industry of like when you slap a white girl's booty. Right. Jeez, where it's
It
is all
okay, that's
part
fair
of
enough.
Universal truths because they're all 11 and they're all learning this shit for the first time.
So do you want to jump to the next one, or we think we got this?
Hold on. Let me hear it one more time.
Hold on. You could. Listen, you want to go full hip?
What?
When you wake up from a one-night stand with thought.
With what?
Thought.
Capital T-H-O-T.
T-H-O-T.
What is that? Oh, man.
What do you think thought means?
It means dat hot old twat.
Not far away.
Thought is a hoe.
Thought is that hoe over there.
Okay, but... Oh, you're Captain Morgan in that?
Well, it has its own... Like, that hoe over there is an abbreviation, but it doesn't necessarily always refer to the acronym, you know? Sometimes
no,
it
just kind of like this.
She a thought.
What if we just did Captain Wakes Up with Thought?
That...
Because again, we could just assume everyone knows who Captain is, starting now. At this moment, it's obvious as fuck. You know, you want to know who the Captain is? Just keep scrolling down.
How the Captain treats Thought?
Or too many words. I mean, Captain waking up Thought.
Thought, Captain.
Captain wakes Thought.
You're awake, pussy. We're so happy to have you.
So then it just becomes Captain blank blanks, and then we're only spending 4.5 characters on Captain, and then we just say what happens. Captain wakes.
Okay, wait, are we shooting ourselves in the foot that we're not saying Captain Morgan?
No. Yes. You know what? The only thing that would be shooting ourselves in the foot is to say Captain Morgan, because that's inviting a cease and desist in about the second
Morgan's
we get...
the real person.
Captain
Henry Morgan was a real person that they co-opted.
So was Walt Disney. I don't know that we could say all this about Walt Disney and make him a character in our shit either.
Here's a fold is...
Hi, Brian. It's me, Walt Disney. I remember Steamboat Willie. He was like, "Hey, I'm Steamboat Willie. I'm an allegory for racism." I was like, "Hey, fuck you, Steamboat Willie. You're a piece of shit."
But if you make the vines directly about the captain, A, you lose that element that we just mentioned of it being some other thing.
Why is that?
If I
did Frosty Wakes Up Thought and it was Frosty the Snowman, that could be from a Frosty thing.
But this clip is not about Frosty.
Well, but it stars Frosty.
Captain Morgan is Frosty the Snowman?
Well, he's the star. You would not acknowledge the star of the vine?
Are you either trying to make a meme as if you were using footage from something else, or are you trying to make this?
I think it's delightful that it looks like it was ripped from something else, but that is, these are comic strips. These are three panel comic strips. We're starting Garfield, only it's called Captain. Or Captain, we could call it Captain Morgan. I think that's problematic.
What did we say? The Captain, right? I
like the Captain. We can do that.
All the Bat Dad shit says, like, you know, like initially it was like Bat Dad does a thing,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
So if all these are like the Captain, the Captain awakens Thought.
I like the Captain wakes Thought. I'm cool with that one right there.
I kind of almost like Captain Pickup Lines.
Awake, pussy! We're so happy to have you. It's Christmas.
No, it's funnier if he's waking up somebody after a one night stand, right? Like that's like the first thing that it's like, you know, instead of like, "Hey, I made you breakfast," it's.
You're awake, pussy! We're so happy to have you. It's Christmas.
I'm down with the Captain Wakes Thought. I think that's succinct and straight to the point.
I'm shocked that we're going full hip.
That's
like,
the thing.
I'm all in, right? But like,
I mean, it's not me. It's just, you know, I'm just reporting. I'm just the conduit.
Is Thought too
media takeout?
Good. Yeah. I mean,
Thought AF. Y'all YOLO my swags.
I mean, so much the better. I mean, it's like...
Do a Google Trends on Thought.
I mean, I think it could... It's one of the things where
it
kind
still
of...
Is it still on the up?
the vast majority of people are going to say, what's a thought? And they're going to type it and they're going to read the Urban Dictionary thing. And then they'll say, oh, that is funny. And that's fine, because that's how every Garfield thing is, except for the part where they say it's funny.
I guess I just am worried that it kind of comes off as two kludgy white dudes who are co-opting their language.
Fucking, we have nothing to do with this. We're just playing from this Christmas special we found.
Shit. Thought peaked in June of this year.
Is that what we're doing? We're chasing trends?
We're chasing.
Like, we're going to find something on his way up and we're going to ride that. Is that the better plan?
No, because we don't know that. Although all of this, I don't know how many people. But no, most people are tweeting or are searching for what is thought.
That's fine.
What has just happened in front of me?
What it means. That's funny.
Oh, wait, no. A lot of people are in Vietnam. Thought urban. Thought meaning. Oh. Thought definition.
Dude, look, I really, when it comes to vines, seems like the only crime is overthinking it. Because certainly the people making them and the people watching them aren't thinking real hard.
Is it all right, Bryce?
Yeah.
You are the canary in the coal mine.
Okay.
When it's like, hey, is a 32-year-old and a 40-year-old trying to be too hip? Are we both turning our hats backward and saying, well, hello, fellow kids, would you like to see my vines? So you are, I feel like he is Brian, he's our ombudsman. Like if we are reaching too hard.
Oh, shit, no, Angry Pasta just nailed it. It's Captain Morning. That's the in the spirit of Garfield, it's like this is what Captain says in the morning. Captain Morning.
Yeah.
It's decided and tabled and we don't have to talk about this anymore.
Okay.
I mean, mainly just because it's like I am so not interested in being right. I'm so interested in being funny and punchy.
All right, so wait, you're saying Captain Morgan?
Captain Morning instead of Captain, I don't know, Captain Morning is all it
you're
needs
awake,
to say.
You're awake, pussy! We're so happy to have you! Christmas!
Again, just like each individual comic strip is never funny in any comic strip book you ever read, the sequence of them all in a row kind of tells this vague...
But nobody's going to watch these in a row.
All of them are going to watch them in a row because...
No. These are all one-note jokes. It's all like you know...
It's not true.
Way Latin people rob.
That's
like...
100...
Give me that money! Like, that's the fucking... That is the extent of all Vine humor.
I don't think that's true. I think that... if you know somebody is like, why is that showing up in my feed? Why is that popular? And then they'll just go to the thing and scroll back and just see nothing but Captain mauled in their faces. But I mean that's fine. In which case we shouldn't post any of these because none of them are complete on their own.
No, I think like headline thing. Like we can make them things,
okay.
But listen, man.
Well, I mean, you tell me. I'm
only one half. Let's put Captain Morning on there, and well, let's see. How about we put specific title?
Relatable.
You're awake, pussy. We're so happy to have you. It's Christmas.
Yeah, I don't think these can survive as standalones. But I mean, that's
which is weird. Like when I see a vine that I see is really popular, I mean, occasionally I will go to look at that person's profile, but mostly I will watch the funny thing multiple times, which makes me feel like that's
correct. But I mean, I might be the first to say this to you, but you're 5 years, 7 years, 8 years older than the vine demographic.
Okay.
They, I mean, people follow Viners for a reason. It's because they want a continuing thing. You'll notice if you go back through people, you know, Viners, they all seem to hit the same kind of note over and over and over again. And it's only in a series. That's why they collect them and post them on YouTube as a series of Lemon videos with Will Sasso or whatever. That's what I thought we were doing, but that's fine. That's, you know, if we're aiming for a different target here,
they're just of a theme.
That's correct. And these don't connect. They're just of a theme. They're all Captain Does Blank, Captain Does Blank, Captain Does Blank. Each one is mildly funny, but in a sequence, i.e. the way they all get posted on YouTube, they get pretty funny, kind of like our cold opens, you know, and so on, is what I was thinking. But maybe we're, you know.
Let's go. I'm in.
Well, what's the next one?
Okay, this is number three.
Captain, you produce movies?
Oh, yeah, I have.
Like what?
Bed Knobs and Broomsticks.
From where?
Inside Angela Lansbury's pussy.
Captain's movie reviews. Captain's movie reviews.
All right, this is four, I think.
Captain, I want to release a vine every day.
I want to release my jizz on your mom.
Captain
Morgan's goals. Captain Morgan's being supportive.
Squad.
Morgan's New Year's resolutions.
Just squad goals.
No,
Captain,
don't stop.
I want to release a vine every day.
I want to release my jizz on your mom.
Captain, I want to release a vine every day.
I want to release my jizz on your mom.
That captain's a real ass.
Captain's newest release.
I like that they're all captains. I like that we've landed there. That's really good.
Yeah, man. I like Captain's newest release.
Okay, then this is the fifth one in this.
Should that be the next one? Should the next one we do be something that like, mentions Vine?
It should be Captain's newest release. And then we can save Captain Morning for later. Captain, how do you make the perfect vine?
You make the perfect vine when you put the time in the vine and you go.
Captain, how do you make the perfect vine?
You make the perfect vine when you put the time in the vine and you go.
I love that one is literally just spearmint nitrate being fuck you guys. Like, he literally just talked and had no sense of how short 6 seconds was.
Yeah. I don't know what to do with that in terms of vines.
Captain, how do you make the perfect vine?
You make the perfect vine when you put the time in the vine and you go.
Captain's recipe?
I think it should be maybe
Captain's perfect vine.
What about, should it reference that subtext to guide people to think about it or no? Like, I don't know. Captain's perfect vine is pretty good.
Now, is
Captain,
it,
how do you make the perfect vine?
You make the perfect vine when you put the time in the vine and you go.
What about like just, God damn it, 6 seconds, ?
Well, is that telegraphing the end?
Captain's Perfect Vine, I watched this probably 12 times and never once thought, oh, this is a commentary on how vines are too short to tell what you really want to say.
That is a fairly common trope on Vine, is people being like, in one way or another, either like being meta about it or having it play as part of a joke where it's like, oh, like, you only have X amount of time before the bomb blows up. Well, I believe, and then it just like restarts. Like that is a common trope.
Yeah. Is it common enough that we don't need to address it?
I don't think this is the best way of addressing it, is what I would say.
So what does that mean in terms of titling it?
Well, I would say not titling it in a way that makes it seem like this is that commentary.
So
I think keeping it about a perfect vine,
okay,
is better. Because
see, if we say Captain's Perfect Vine, I mean, I don't know. Then and it might be funny enough, just as
Captain, how do you make the perfect vine?
Gibberish.
You make the perfect vine when you put the time in the vine and you go.
What's that? Actually saying that nobody looks at titles on vines.
Man,
a lot of times I look at them because of the way they get embedded. You won't see them until after it started playing, and they're only 6 seconds, so you've already seen it.
Captain's rules for a perfect vine. So, Captain's rules for a perfect vine.
I like that.
And then what? No. In the context, let's hear it under Captain's rules for a perfect vine.
Captain, how do you make the perfect vine?
You make the perfect vine when you put the time in the vine and you go.
Okay, that's actually pretty good.
Okay. I think that's all.
Yeah, that's four.
Five. Oh, no, four. Yeah.
Captain Morgan explores the short nature of vine videos while attempting to create a rhyme.
Dude, are you
hashtag
limited?
Commentary.
Are you limited? Are you limited on the length of the titles that you're able to do?
I don't know. Wait, flying spacebar. Has anyone seen flying Pop-Tart cat around?
Not for a while.
Is that flying? Is flying spacebar flying Pop-Tart cat?
I caught Brad Leclerc saying something in the chat earlier that indicated that he had also quit his day job. Is that a true thing, Brad Leclerc?
Stop scooping my heat, fucker.
Nah. Dude, I owe a deep debt to one Brad Leclerc.
I'm sorry.
Flying Spacebar is different from Flying
Spacebar. I apologize to Brad Leclerc. And I would also like to apologize for Flying Spacebar for thinking he or she was flying Pop-Tart Cat.
Yeah, flying Pop-Tart Cat. Holy cow, you did. Thank you very much, Brad, for setting us up with Shopify when you did. That was very, very cool and earned it up. take two. Ended up being a really good call.
Yeah.
Good for you, man.
So Captain Morgan is based off of a pirate, Henry Morgan, who has been used and referenced constantly in video games, in comic books, in Assassin's Creed Black Flag, in music, in movies.
Yeah, do they call him Henry Morgan or Captain Morgan?
Good question, but obviously Captain Morgan the Rum. Captain Axe Hand Morgan.
They called me the Axe Hand.
Why is that, Captain?
Because I got a handful of your mom's axe wound. Ho ho! Vagina things is what I say. Whoa!
I thought it would be because axe sounds like ass.
You're wrong!
Alucard, I don't think that's true at all. I think that's the reason they call it Captain Morgan and not Henry Morgan rum is because you couldn't call it Abraham Lincoln wine, but you could call it Savior Lincoln. And then anyone else who said Savior Lincoln would be violating your trademark. That's why you make trademarks. Trust it from a guy who has to deal with trademarks.
So in 1944, the Seagram Company started producing rum under the name Captain Morgan Rum Company.
Captain Morgan is a registered trademark. Retail store services including rum and rum-based products, apparel and accessories, housewares, jewelry, gift novelties, office and stationery supplies, as well as educational and entertainment services, namely guided tours of a rum distillery and adjoining visitor center, including information regarding alcoholic beverages, brand history, and the distillation process.
Oh, shit, son.
That does sound vines, like fucker. Welcome to the open seas.
it's international waters. Is that true, Captain Morgan? Full
sail ahead, Brian.
Well, the problem is that
Brian, number one, fucking in international waters, trademarks don't apply. You know what they call me when we get outside 30 miles of the land?
Just another bottle of rum?
Tommy Hilfiger. Fuck off, they get so here.
Though it would be tough for you to make merchandise.
Fuck him.
And by him, I mean Diageo rum distillery people. They ripped me off, those fuckers. I'm a Welsh privateer. Have I told you my history? I made myself famous during activities in the Caribbean. Primarily, I raided Spanish settlements and was considered a pirate only to the Spanish. You want to know why?
Why, Captain Morgan?
Thank you, Bryce.
Sorry.
It's a two-man routine.
I'm sorry. Look,
Captain Morgan's adrift.
It's one in the morning.
Oh, Jesus.
Sorry.
And, it's past one in the morning.
I was born on August 25th, 1688. No, wait. That was when I died in Lawrence Field, Jamaica.
No, I'm sorry to hear that, Captain.
Hold on. Wait a minute. I'm going to do the rest of this while somebody with your shirt comes on screen. Hold on, Brian. It's a stunt double, Brian.
Oh, shit. Oh! That's amazing.
Brian, it's like you're looking into a mirror.
There we go.
Yeah. Oh, no. It's all of the captain's fantasies are coming true. Ahoy.
Double the freshness, double your cum.
Oh, shit. All right. Let's shut this fucker down.
All right. Good night, everybody. Say good night.
Bye, guys. Love you.
Thanks.